Hello friends, today we are discussing about the genomic selection, which is a very important strategy. So what is genomic selection and why genomic selection? In this video we will discuss only about why we need genomic selection, and in another video we will discuss about actually what is genomic selection. So genomic selection is a specialized form of marker assisted selection in which information from genotype data on marker alleles covering the entire genome forms the basis of selection. It means in case of genomic selection, we are using the more number of marker as compared to traditional marker assisted selection, where we are using the very dense or highly saturated genetic map. It means we are doing genotyping with the help of more number of markers, and then we are using this information for selection purpose. So this is called the genomic selection. Okay, so actually this is genomic selection, where we use the training population and breeding population, and on the basis of the GEBB, genomic estimated breeding value, we are doing selection. But in this video we will not discuss about genomic selection, only we will discuss about why we need this genomic selection strategy, why we need this training and breeding population. So why genomic selection? If we have already marker assisted backcrossing and marker assisted recurrent selection, then why we need genomic selection? First, we all know that the traditional marker assisted selection or marker assisted selection is well suited only for handling the oligo gene or major gene, or we can say the QTL with large effect. It means marker assisted selection is mainly suitable for those QTLs which have large effect. It is not suitable for minor gene which have very small effect. So we divide marker assisted selection into marker assisted backcrossing, MABB, you can see, and MARS, marker assisted recurrent selection. So first, what is marker assisted backcross breeding? We all know that you can say this is marker assisted backcrossing from IRI website. So in case of marker assisted backcrossing, we are taking one donor variety and one recurrent parent. So from donor we are transferring the gene from donor to the recipient variety, and with the help of markers we are doing selection. So marker assisted backcrossing definitely reduce the number of backcrosses as compared to the traditional plant breeding. But what is the disadvantage of this marker assisted backcrossing is that in case of recipient variety, we are transferring any desirable allele or trait. So whatever variety we are obtaining after marker assisted backcrossing, it have only those gene or those new gene or those new trait which have donor. It means we are not creating any new gene combination in case of marker assisted backcrossing. We are transferring only those gene which exist in donor variety. So you can see marker assisted backcrossing is in conservation strategy. It improves the recurrent parent only to the extent specified by the introgress gene or QTL which is present in case of donor variety. It does not generate new gene combination that may be expected to enhance the performance potential and adaptation of the selected genotype. So this is the drawback of marker assisted backcrossing. And we all know that the mass have one technique, MARS, marker assisted recurrent selection. So you can see this is the marker assisted recurrent selection given by Mewison and reference is Janier. So in marker assisted backcrossing, we have three cycles, but I will not discuss. I will discuss only the drawback of this marker assisted recurrent selection. In case of marker assisted recurrent selection, we are using only those markers which are showing the significant association with the trait. We are not using those markers which are showing the insignificant association with the trait. It means we are using the less number of marker in case of marker assisted recurrent selection. But in case of genomic selection, we are using those markers, either they are showing significant association or either they are not showing insignificant association with the trait. It means we are using all markers in case of genomic selection. That's why we are getting more information. So for obtaining the solution of this MABP and MARS, we have the technique genomic selection, which is given by Mewison to rectify the deficiency of mass and MARS scheme. The GS scheme utilize information from genome by marker data whether or not their association with the concentrate are significant. So this is the genomic selection technique. We will discuss the genomic selection technique in the in the separate video where I will discuss about the training population, breeding population, how genotyping, how we are selecting the lines on the basis of GABB value. So thank you all of you for watching this video.